There's a lot of information on a DNA molecule. Explain what is called the sequence hypothesis.
Yeah, so Francis Crick formulated this idea of the sequence hypothesis in 1958, and the basic idea was that the chemical subunits along the spine of the DNA are functioning like alphabetic characters in a written language, or digital characters like the zeros and ones in a section of software, which is to say, what gives those parts of the DNA and the DNA molecule as a whole its function, its ability to direct the construction of proteins, is not anything about the physical properties of the chemical parts of DNA per se, but rather it's their arrangement, their specific arrangement in accord with an independent symbol convention, which was later discovered and is now known as the genetic code. So you've got a genetic text that is translated by a genetic code. And what was actually discovered was a complex information storage, transmission, and processing system inside every living cell of every living organism. The thing about the information in DNA is that the arrangement of those bases, those nucleotide bases, the chemical subunits, is critical to function. So when we think about DNA, we don't just have a complex arrangement of characters or a random arrangement of characters. What we have is a complex arrangement. It's not something where you have repetition of the same characters over and over again, like a mantra or like a crystal of salt where you have NaCl, NaCl. But instead what you have is a very irregular arrangement, a complex arrangement, which is nevertheless highly specific in order to perform a function. So in the information sciences, we make a distinction between complex sequences, which would be kind of a random gibberish, and specified complex sequences, which is what we have in DNA. So it's a very special kind of information that we associate with only two other things in all of human experience. One is written language, and the other is machine code or digital code. And so we have the same kind of information in DNA, which in our experience always points to a designing intelligence. Bill Gates has said that DNA is like a software program, but much more complex than any we've ever created, and he's absolutely right. But software comes from a programmer, and written text comes from writers. And so when we find this type of information, known as specified complexity, inside a living cell, we're very justified in inferring that a designing agent played a role.
Yeah, everybody out there's got a computer. If somebody comes over and says, hey, let me just kind of dink around with your code and then change it a little bit, what would you say to that? You say, no way.
It doesn't work. I ask this question hypothetically when I give talks at universities, and programmers always laugh. You know, if you start changing the arrangement of a functioning section of software by chance,
your computer will not
work. Will you build a new program or will you destroy the function? And you will destroy the function of the existing code long before you ever get to a new program or operating system.